on this earth is the most popular name? What name? There's no debate, no argument that the most popular name on this earth is Muhammad.
The Quran says, certainly there is for you human beings and believers in the Messenger of God, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the most profound pattern of human behavior. Now that's a challenge that God has made to the world. Now this challenge must mean that it should be able to be proven that Muhammad categorically is the most profound human being that has impacted upon humanity. That's what it means.
The life of Muhammad is, even in its details, probably better known than any other major religious figure before modern times.
Who's the most profound human being that has impacted on humanity in documented history? Who is it? Well, I'll give you a hint. Five biographers of this age, five graduate, premier biographers of our age, all of them non-Muslims, did a study to determine the 100 most profound human beings that have impacted upon history. Three of them conclusively said that it is Muhammad ibn Abdullah. Muhammad ibn Abdullah, and one of them whose name was Michael H. Hart. Now you can go check this out for yourselves. Michael H. Hart, he said that his choice would have naturally been Jesus Christ because he's a Christian. But he had to admit that Jesus Christ was not a father. He was not a husband. He was not a ruler. And he was not a statesman. So just on those issues, he said that he had to acquiesce to Muhammad, peace and blessings.
Among the sacred texts that Zechariah writes is the Hilya, a portrait of the prophet in words.
Transmitted from Ali, who, when asked to describe the prophet, would say, his face was not narrow, nor was it fully round, but there was a little bit of roundness to it. When he looked at someone, he looked at them with his face turned perfectly towards them. Whoever saw him unexpectedly was in awe of him, and whoever associated with him familiarly loved him. Anyone who would describe him would say, I never saw before him or after him the like of him. Peace be upon him.
Muhammad was always very insistent that he was not a divine figure, and he always warned his followers not to do with him what the Christians had done to Jesus and put him on a pedestal and say that he was God or divine. He was not. He was an ordinary human being, and the Muslims have taken that seriously. But what they do say is that Muhammad is the perfect man. That if you look at Muhammad, you can see how a perfect act of surrender to the divine can be made.
In Mecca, where he was born, he was known as Al-Amin, the most trustworthy. And Al-Amin, even though his enemies had stolen from his followers, killed his followers, tortured his followers, confiscated their properties, he could have done what others do in warfare. He could have then confiscated their wealth that he was holding. But when they entered his home to kill him, they did not find him there. Instead, they found his cousin Ali radiallahu anhu, and he left Ali in his house when he escaped, for only one reason: so that Ali radiallahu anhu could give back to them the valuables, the money, that they had entrusted with him years ago. Can you imagine a man who is hated for his message, opposed for his message, sought to be killed? Yet those people who hated the message and sought to kill him, they never thought to come and say, give us back our money. Because still they trusted him. Because they knew there was no one with more trust in Mecca than Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
He said, I was amongst the crowd hustling and jostling and shoving to come and see the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he said, when I saw him, the first impression I had of him, he said, I knew that his face was not the face of a liar. This is not a man that told lies. In other words, the honesty and the beauty, the inner beauty and the outer beauty combined. Abdullah ibn Salam saw this from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he said he accepted Islam right then and there. In other words, Abdullah ibn Salam converted just by seeing the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and then hearing the very first words that came out of his mouth. Such was the power, such was the beauty, such was the perfection that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam with.
The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was even compassionate towards the animals and the insects. One time they were out towards a battle. Suddenly the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam stopped the whole army. And he said, there is a bird above me fluttering. Why is the bird fluttering above you, Ya Rasulullah? He said, she is crying because someone has taken her babies from its nest. Who took them? And a young man came along and said, Ya Rasulullah, I did. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, why? Why do you want to hurt the feelings of this mother by taking her children? Return them back. In fact, the Prophet ﷺ used to say, anyone who kills a bird for no reason, on the day of judgment will come to Allah crying and saying, my Lord, your servant so-and-so killed me and he had no reason for killing me. No.
O mankind, listen well. I may not be with you much longer. The weak among you, feed them on what you eat, dress them as you are dressed. You will meet your God, and he will call you to account for your actions. Let those who are present warn those who are absent. You are all descended from Adam, and the best among you is he who most regards God. Let all your feuds be abolished. You must know that every Muslim is the brother of every other Muslim, and all Muslims are brothers one of another. Between Muslims there are no races and no tribes. Nor must you take anything from your brother except what is given freely. Do not oppress, and do not be oppressed. Be that the angel of death will visit me soon, and death will overtake me. But I have left you a book, revealed by God, the Quran.